All right, hello everybody. I'm going to tell you about how to use an app called Avenza Maps to view and keep things like track logs and waypoints using our Atlas-3 PDF square maps. Now, the really nice thing about this setup is you don't need an internet connection to do it. So once you set it up, you can set it up at home where you've got an internet connection. Once you've got it set up, you can go anywhere in the province with a mobile device, and you'll be able to navigate on your Atlas square maps and see where point counts, locations are, keep track logs and things like that. All you need is to get it set up in the first place. So the app is free. It's called Avenza Maps. It's available for Android and Apple devices. The free version lets you have up to three square maps, or any three PDF maps. They don't have to be square maps, but three PDF maps can be loaded up in the free version at any one time. If you want to have more than three at a time, then you need to use the paid version. So it's a real handy app. You don't have to do this at all, but if you're inclined, you might find this helpful. So the first thing you need to do is download the app onto your phone. The next thing you need to do is you need to get the square map that you're interested in. So to do that, you want to head to the Atlas website, birdsontario.org. Under the Tools and Resources menu, select Square Resources. That will load up a map of the province. Once that loads up, you're going to zoom in to your location where the square is that you're interested in. The square will show up once you zoom in far enough. Once you do, the boundary will show up, and as well the point count locations and eBird hotspots will show up. If you move the map, the center will always dictate which square shows up, so you can move it back and forth until you've got the correct square. The square number will show up in the top right, and then there's a bunch of tools available for this square. You want to click on the download PDF map option. That will download it to your computer, and you can open that file up right in your web browser or with something like Adobe Acrobat Reader, and you can look at all the details of your square map. It'll have all the point count locations on the map, as well as all sorts of other handy details like most road names. You can see on this map the small tiny roads within the city of Peterborough. Their names aren't showing up, but most of the other sort of country roads will show up, so good enough to get you navigating around. So once you've downloaded the Atlas square map that you're interested in, you need to get that over to your mobile device. You can do that lots of different ways. You could download it directly with your phone or tablet or whatever device you're using. You could email it to yourself. That's what a lot of people end up doing. You can transfer it directly with a USB cable and so on. Once you've got it on your mobile device, then you need to open up the app on the device. So we're going to open up Avenza. We're going to click the little plus icon and then select download or import a map from storage locations. Find the square map file. It'll load it up. Take a few seconds to process it. Then you can open up the map and you can look around. You can zoom in, zoom out, move around, see all the details that are on the map. And thanks to the GPS that's built into your device, you should be showing up with a little blue marker like you see in the bottom right that shows you where you are. And so if you start driving around the square or walking around, that blue marker should move along with you. So there's lots of handy things you can do with Avenza. I mean, you can just see all the details of the square, but you can do things like record a track log. So to access the track log recording, you want to click the three dots in the bottom right and then select record GPS tracks. If that option pops up, just ignore it. You want to click start tracking. That'll start the track log. You can lower that little menu to get it out of the way. And then you can start walking or driving or whatever, and it'll be recording your track as you go. Now, a handy feature to point out at this point, the little crosshairs icon in the very bottom left, if you click that, that will center the map right on you. It'll move those gray crosshairs over your marker. And if you're doing a track log, if you click that button, it will lock that marker or the crosshairs to your location, so it'll move along with you. So keep the map centered around your location until you move it. So the track log, very handy to use. If you click those three little dots in the bottom right, there's the option to, or if you pull that menu back up, you can turn the track log off or pause it or whatever, in order to save it for future. Another handy feature that you can do is you can drop little markers on the map, so waypoints, or Avenza calls them place markers. So to access that option, you're going to click the little place marker icon just to the right of the crosshairs, so bottom left there between the coordinates and the crosshair icon. So you want to navigate to the place you want to drop the marker, then click the icon, and it'll bring up the place mark options. There's lots of things you can adjust there. You can give it a name, you can give it some details. So this is a very handy way to save a specific location. Maybe you saw some interesting habitat you want to come back to, or you had an interesting bird that you want to make note of to come back to, or something like that. So lots of handy features. These are just a couple to add place marks and add the track logs. Anything you add to the map within Avenza, it'll be there when you come back. So if you close Avenza now and then come back a day later, turn it back on, those features should all be saved on your map. So a really handy way to keep track of all sorts of details. You know, maybe over the course of a season, you can keep track of all your track logs and see all the parts of the square that you've covered. Now, one last little feature I want to point out is a way to keep the screen on. So this is really handy if you've got the phone running with the map and you're driving around, for instance, and you want to keep it on so you can navigate. So you don't want it to shut off just because you're not touching the screen. So to do that, you have to back out of the particular map and go to the settings option, then click on the map view. And then there's a little option there, keep screen on. So once you've done that, you're all set. You can head back into the map and the screen will stay on, even if you're not touching it constantly. So the app is very handy to use. It's great. It works with our PDF maps. And as I said, it's a really useful feature, really useful app for navigating, especially when you're going to be out of cell service, so you can't use something like Google Maps. Avenza Maps will work no problem anywhere in the province. You don't have to have cell service or an internet connection, as long as you've got the PDF maps already downloaded onto your device.